We turn now to some quite remarkable news from the frontiers of developing new cancer treatments. Now, normally when we do that, we have to leave New Zealand, but this is very much a Kiwi-made affair. The country's first ever clinical trial of a cancer treatment called CAR T-cell therapy is getting underway after receiving final regulatory approval. This is big. Obviously, it's a trial, so the results will determine efficacy and effectiveness, and we don't want to prejudge that. But there's growing excitement about the potential for this target, for this treatment to target certain cancers, including some types of leukemia, lymphoma and myelomas. And in this case, patients with a type of non-Hodgkin lymphoma who've exhausted other treatment options. That's an important detail and we'll discuss that shortly. The trial's been conducted by the Malaghan Institute as part of its potentially breakthrough development of new CAR T-cell technology. And to explain how it all works and what, fingers crossed, it might do, and to tell us more about the clinical trial, we're delighted to welcome to the program the Malaghan Institute's clinical director, Dr. Robert Weinkove. Robert, it's lovely to have you with us. Thank you. I was watching a lovely TED talk you gave in which you described your dad, who was also a doctor, having a weight loss, running a weight loss operation. Right. What was his motto?
His motto was, "We hope to see less of you," which I think is fantastic. And ultimately, that's our role as clinicians, as doctors. We want to try and make, if we can, people's illnesses a smaller part of their lives. And we don't know whether this trial is going to be the right step towards that, but I think it's progress towards what hopefully in the long run will be better and perhaps less toxic therapies for some people.
Yes, wouldn't it be wonderful if we saw less of our cancer patients? Wouldn't that be a remarkable breakthrough? So how does CAR T-cell therapy work?
So it's a slightly different treatment to some of the conventional ways we treat cancers, particularly lymphomas, which this trial is in. And instead of using chemotherapy or more conventional immune therapies, what this involves is taking patients' immune cells out. We take them out by a process called leukapheresis. It's done at the New Zealand Blood Service. So we take out some cells from the patient. We take them off to our specialized laboratories at the Malaghan Institute. And we process them. We basically redirect the immune cells, reprogram them to direct them against targets on the cancer cells, on the lymphoma cells. We grow them up in the lab. We then have to run a series of safety tests on the cells. And once they're suitable for release, we bring the patient into hospital, give them a small dose of what we call conditioning chemotherapy so that their body can accept the new cells, and then give the cells back to them through their veins. And that's really what the treatment involves. After that, there's then a close period of monitoring because there can be toxicities, fevers and inflammation and so on. But this type of treatment has shown some real successes in some trials overseas, and it's becoming a standard of care in some other countries. We can't yet offer that routinely in New Zealand, but we hope to be able to pave the way through clinical trials like ours.
It's really important with cancer treatments to not get carried away until the trials demonstrate absolute efficacy, because false hope, I guess, is a terrible thing, right? But there is a very real sense of excitement about CAR T-cell therapy, isn't there?
There is, and that's based on other trials that have been done overseas in the US, in China, where our collaborators, Wellington Jiaotai Therapies Limited, are based. There's a real sense that in numerous trials, we've seen some patients having very good responses. Now, it's not everybody. And even in the best trials of the best therapies to date, there's only a fraction of people who enjoy really good long-term responses. But there are some, including prominent New Zealanders, who've had some really good responses.
Absolutely.
To this treatment.
Yes.
And so we'll be really keen to try and bring that modality of treatment here. We've called this trial Enable, and there's a reason for that. We don't know what the results of this study will be, but what we hope it can do is enable the clinical setup, the regulatory setup, to allow us to accelerate the use of these types of treatments here where they're proven to be effective in the future.
And also, and I found this absolutely fascinating, this is for patients who have exhausted other treatment options, right? Why is that?
This is a phase one trial, so it's a first phase one study. We're generating the cells here in New Zealand, and we don't yet know how safe and effective it is. So when you first do a trial like that, it's really important that we need to enroll people who haven't got other treatment options, because we don't yet know whether the treatment will be safe. We don't yet know whether it will be effective. We've got good reason to think it may well be effective, but we have to do this in people who've exhausted other treatment options. So this trial won't be for everybody, and we'll be encouraging people who think they might be eligible to speak to their own clinicians.
So to be blunt and brutal and unsentimental about it, and forgive me, and if I'm wrong, please correct me, but in normal circumstances, the patients you are dealing with would be stage four or terminal?
That's right. I mean, if people had other potentially curative options, we wouldn't be advising them to take part in the study. That's right.
And so those people, one imagines, would be desperate to get into this trial. And it's very important that they're working with their oncologist rather than coming direct to you. But how will the trial participants be selected?
So we've got some quite stringent inclusion and exclusion criteria. These have been agreed by the trial management committee. We're also lucky to have a data safety monitoring committee, including some overseas clinicians with experience of these types of treatment. And we've really designed those criteria to select people who we think are not going to be put at undue risk from toxicities of the treatment. Those criteria are not dissimilar to the kind of criteria we might use to decide if somebody would go ahead with a bone marrow transplant, for instance.
One final question. We're just going to the 7 o'clock news, and I'm naughty even asking it, but I know how much this means to you, and you have a very real sense of excitement about this, don't you?
I do. I think it's a new modality of treatment for us here in New Zealand. There's good proof of principle this kind of treatment can work very well. So, yeah, we're really excited to be able to offer this here, and it's a major milestone for us. It really is.
Dr. Robert Weinkove from the Malaghan Institute, we look forward to talking to you about how the trial's going. And
thanks,
once
Tom.
You have those results, thanks so much for joining us this morning. We really do wish you well.
Thank you.